Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship service this morning to everyone who's here. Also, several people joining us on different platforms. Welcome to everyone. We're going to start this morning with Lego.
I don't believe it.
You're not the only one.
Huh?
I said you're not the only one who doesn't believe. Thomas seems to have had the same problem.
No, Noreen, that's my point. I don't believe.
Uh-huh.
That Thomas didn't believe.
What's that one more time?
I don't believe that Thomas didn't believe.
Oh, I see. But why do you say that?
Well, the disciples were certain that Jesus was dead.
Of course they were. He had died on Friday. He had been buried.
Yes, but on Sunday evening, Jesus appeared in their midst.
Poof! He had been raised from the dead.
I know, and that is such life-changing, smile-inducing news.
It is for me. I spent all last week smiling during our Easter celebrations.
Problem was, Thomas wasn't there when Jesus visited.
Yeah, that was too bad. He must have felt left out.
Worse than that, when the disciples told him what he missed, he didn't believe.
So?
So, how could he not believe such wonderful news?
Well, I see your point, Lego.
See?
But I see Thomas's point, too. Put yourself into Thomas's shoes, Lego.
You mean his sandals?
Okay, his sandals, then. Thomas was terribly sad, sad and scared. His Lord and his friend had been murdered. The same people who had Jesus crucified may be out after the disciples.
Ooh, that is scary. To have lost your best friend and to be hiding for your life as well?
And don't forget the most important part, Lego.
What's that, Noreen?
Lego, no one had ever risen from the dead before.
Oh, I guess you're right.
Thomas was hearing news that was too good to be true. And as my dad always said, if something seems too good to be true...
It usually isn't true. I know. Thomas's experience reminds me of bubblegum wrappers.
What?
Yeah. Once I saw an ad in a comic book for a life-size skeleton. All I had to do was collect 72 bubblegum wrappers and send $1 to an address. It seemed too good to be true.
And what happened?
Well, I sent off the bubblegum wrappers and I waited. As I waited, I planned out all of the great things I could do with the skeleton. Scare my sister, hang it in my room, learn about human anatomy.
And?
Well, after 6 weeks, the package came. I opened it up to find a sheet of cheap plastic with a skeleton printed on one side.
Too good to be true.
Well, after that experience, I don't think I would have believed the disciples' story either.
But Lego, that's really the whole point of Easter.
Yeah?
It's much too good to be true, but it is true. Jesus really has risen from the grave.
No more doubting.
And no more too good to be true.
Because it is true. Jesus is risen. Alleluia!
Amen.
And as they're leaving for Sunday school, we'll have our opening video.
Last week, we celebrated Easter. We remembered the resurrection, and we worshiped a Savior who defeated sin, conquered death, and changed our eternity forever. Now, the work begins. For the miracle of Easter was never meant to be kept secret. It was never meant to be quiet. Instead, it was meant to change hearts and lead people to Jesus. Easter was the beginning of our calling, a mission to share the love of Christ, this unimaginable hope, with the world. For even now, the echoes of the resurrection remind us, our work is not finished. For our mandate remains the same, to share the hope of Jesus and the life-changing power of the resurrection to the ends of the earth. This is the work of Easter.
I'll ask you to stand and join with me as we give thanks for baptism. Continuing then in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God. For in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. Through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your Son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By water and your word, you claim us as daughters and sons, making us heirs of your promise and servants of all. We praise you for the gift of water that sustains life. And above all, we praise you for the gift of new life in Jesus Christ. Shower us with your Spirit and renew our lives with your forgiveness, grace, and love. To you be given honor and praise through our Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. We'll remain standing for our opening hymn.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder and leaves us breathless in awe and wonder, the King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Who breaks the chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who rules the nations with truth and justice? Shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That we would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, you sing for all that you've done for me.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, with joy we celebrate the day of our Lord's resurrection. By the grace of Christ among us, enable us to show the power of your resurrection in all that we say and do. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated for the reading.
Our psalm today is Psalm 133, and it's read responsively. How good and how pleasant it is when kindred live together in unity.
It is like fine oil upon the head, flowing down. The beard of Aaron, flowing down upon the collar of his robe.
It is like the dew of Hermon, flowing down upon the hills of Zion. For there the Lord has commanded the blessing, life forevermore. Our reading today is from Acts chapter 4, verses 32 to 35. Now the whole group of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one claimed private ownership of any possessions, but everything they owned was held in common. With great power, the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as owned lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold. They laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. This is the word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
I'll ask you to stand and join with me for the gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Holy Gospel this day, a reading from the book of St. John in the 20th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
And when it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. And then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with him when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my finger in the mark of the nails and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." And then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." And Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." And Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. I have a company tie that I wear. This one is the company tie. Now you'll notice what the company tie says on it. And immediately I get two reactions to this. The first one is this. Oh yeah, you're that church guy. Not anything about our relationship, just I'm that church guy. The other one is, wow, were you gifted that or did you actually get that from the movie? Because you see, this is exactly the line that's repeated over and over and over again in the Blues Brothers. Now, some of you may not know that movie. If you don't, I recommend you take a look at it. It's got some awesome, well, now wait a minute, I'm dating myself. Yes, thank you. Some of the younger crew up here, they're going, "Hey, that music's not that awesome." And I'm going, "Oh, yes, it is. Depends on when you grew up." But it has some great music and some great singers in it. Indeed, it does. But the whole point is, we're all on that same mission, and so are the two guys in the movie. And you're going, "No, they're not." And they're not because we don't think of them that way, because they're two grifting con men who are out to raise money for their old parochial Catholic school sent by a crusty old nun. And what they're doing is they're trying to scam everybody in sight. That doesn't sound like much of a mission from God. And yet it points exactly to what Jesus is doing this morning. He's going, "Guys, move it. I don't want you sitting here. I don't want you hiding out. I don't want you in the back. I don't want you behind locked doors." Now, I'm not even going to begin to go this morning into the fact that these people are hiding from their people. Oh, there's a whole couple, three layers built behind that one, where the Jews are hiding from the Jews because all the disciples are Jewish. As importantly, notice that Jesus doesn't want anybody left out. So he says, fine, Thomas is around, we'll do it again. That's not the first time that's happened. All you have to do is look at Exodus and Deuteronomy, and you have do-overs happening. That's because Moses gets a little excited. He breaks the first set of tablets, and now we have to have the tablets 2.0. That's just one example. The point of the matter is, they're to get out there and to get going. They're to bear witness. They're to do things. And I had a person come to me one day, and she said to me, Pastor, I can't do it. I said, what? She says, I'm no good. I'm not much good in crowds, and I'm certainly no public speaker. And then she said, not like you. And I go, yeah, well, that doesn't mean you can't help. She says, how? I said, do it. Don't use any words. Just go do it. Help, assist, love, care. This is the work of discipleship. This is the work of spreading the gospel because we care and love for one another that much. The whole book of Acts is filled with this. Healing and restoration and caring. It's all out there. This is where we begin now, and this is where we grow into. And sometimes it's getting out of the road. I watched this happen yesterday morning on public transit. There's this guy standing there waiting for a bus. There's three or four other folks gathered around, me included, except I'm back in the terminal because I have no idea about how this works. I don't take the bus that much. But what happened was the bus pulled up, and immediately everybody looked at this older person, and you know they were older because, hey, it's completely snow on the top, and they stepped back. Now I'm watching the gospel in action. They haven't said anything. They step back and they allow this poor woman to shuffle forward and climb onto the bus, which was down low. And she made it quite nicely. And she turned as she hit the doorway and said, thank you. This is the gospel in action. Then I watched it happen again because I watched something I've never seen. Especially in big cities. I've never seen this. The driver said to her, good morning. I hope you have a good drive. I was amazed. The bus drivers never talk to you. They sit there going, we're here. Gonna get this done. This, dear friends, is just one small example of the gospel in action. And her bit in it was to just be kind and be gracious and say, oh, thank you for all of that. That's where we find the gospel. Now, I can guarantee you that this day and this week, you're going to get a chance to do this kind of discipleship. More than one, probably. And all Jesus asks is this, that we step up. Keep your eyes open. You never know where it's going to happen. Amen.
Crown him with many crowns, the Lamb upon his throne. Hark how the heavenly anthem drowns all music but its own. O soul and sin of him who died for thee, and hail him as thy matchless king throughout eternity. Crown him the Lord of life, who triumphed o'er the grave and rose victorious in the stripe for the
confess together our common faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and Son is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love triumphed over fear, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those who are in need.
Your church cries out, O God. And you listen. As you drew near to the disciples, draw near to us this day. Breathe on us your Holy Spirit, that our faith is renewed and we witness to your love. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Your creation cries out, O God, and you listen. Nurture trees, crops, wildflowers, and all growing things. Guide farmers, gardeners, arborists, and others who tend the soil and nurture plants into life. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Your world cries out, O God, and you listen. Guide police, firefighters, paramedics, and other first responders to work for the well-being of communities and the dignity of every person, that no one may need to live in fear. God of grace,
hear our prayer. Your children cry out, O God, and you listen. Hear your people crying out for justice, for an end to racism and other oppression, and for a world where all are fed and safe. We pray for all who cry out in suffering or in pain, and to those whom we know that are afflicted, that we name from our hearts, we add these people: Phil, Leslie and Toby, Nathaniel, Gary, Linda, Jackson, Ann, Orest, Martin, Pam, Viola, Tommy, Nick, Nikki, Sarah, Diane, Chris and Riley, Kelsey, Ken, Bob, Tammy and Tiffany, Howie, Phyllis, and Eric. Extend your renewing and restoring hand as is in your will. God of grace,
hear our prayer. Your congregations cry out, O God, and you listen. Renew pastors, deacons, musicians, and other staff administrators, and volunteers who facilitated Holy Week and Easter worship. Open our hearts to discern where God calls each of us to serve. God of grace,
hear our prayer. Accept our gratitude, O God, for the lives of those who now rest in you. Grant us your peace amid our fears. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
We share the peace.
Yeah. most of them. Sorry.
And as you're finding your places again, I'll ask you to stand and join with me once more. My dear friends, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Taste and see that the Lord is good. You may be seated for the distribution. I would note for you once more that we have both bread and gluten-free wafers as well. If you need gluten-free, please ask. We also have wine and grape juice.
Thank you.
of grace is Jesus my Redeemer. There is no more in heaven now to give. He is my joy, my righteousness and freedom, my steadfast love, my dear.
Jesus, now and ever is my plea.
though my lips shall repeat, yet not I, but through Christ in me. Yet not I, but through Christ in me.
Ask you to stand and join with me. And now, dear friends, may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Life-giving God, in the mystery of Christ's resurrection,
you send light to conquer darkness, water to give new life, and the bread of life to nourish your people. Send us forth as witnesses to your Son's resurrection, that we may show your glory to all the world. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Amen. And now receive the blessing of the Lord. May God, our Creator, bless and keep us this day. May Jesus, our risen Lord and Savior, bless and keep us this day. And may the Holy Spirit bless and keep us this day in power and in strength. Amen. You may be seated. We have a few announcements. I'm going to start with a couple of birthdays this week. Caleb Blair has a birthday on the 11th. And then some guy named Jason, or I think it's Jason O, or is it Jackson O? It's one or the other. He's over here, and it's his birthday on the 13th. So we need to sing happy birthday to them.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, God bless you, happy birthday to you.
Couple of other events very quickly. ICPM lunch is coming up in 3 weeks. Check the newsletter, please. Also, 2 weeks from now, you need to plan to stay because it's Sunday Sunday. Now, I said that to somebody I was visiting this past week, and they had no idea what a Sunday Sunday was. So I had to explain to them that this is taking a Sunday and dousing it in everything that you ever had your heart's desire set on, sprinkles, chocolate, caramel, whatever, and you were eating it on Sunday. I said, therefore, it's Sunday, Sunday. And they went, oh, this was a major revelation, apparently, but never mind. So that's happening in 2 weeks. Please make sure you've saved room off from breakfast, if you have breakfast. Now, Lawrence, if you would.
I don't know how many people know, but with our fall supper money, we did buy a riding lawnmower.
Woo-hoo. Yes, yes.
And we'll probably be using it, or I shouldn't say probably, we will be using it, and I would like a lot of help on May the 4th. We're going to have, it's a Saturday, and we're going to have a cleanup at the church, so we'll be mowing our lawns, we'll be doing other stuff.
Okay. Wayne, you're up.
We will be adding a link to with our agreement with them and with our secondment agreement, so everybody can read through this. And then the following Sunday, which is next Sunday, the 14th, we'll have a. You can bring all your questions and concerns and or whatever with this, and we'll try and answer them for you. So make sure you read those this coming week in the letter that comes out. And or you can send your questions to one of the call committee members, which is myself, Laura Haugen, and Myron Kostick as well. And we just want to make sure that everybody understands what's going on and what we're doing. And it'll be, all be written out there. Okay? Thanks.
Thank you. Nancy.
Yes, I have just a couple of them. One is a reminder that the last Wednesday of every month, we get together as ladies and bring your favorite coffee mug. And if you want, you can bring snacks. There's always snacks there, though. So if you're not able to do that, just come on by. All are welcome. And we sit around. We have a little bit of time of fellowship, so we get to know one another a little bit better, because that's always nice to connect and find out what's happening in people's lives. But another part is that we have a small devotional, and we just find out what other people's needs are so that we can stay connected, but also that we can, not just on one day of the month, but then throughout the month, we can find out what the needs are and then be able to connect throughout the month as well. So then the other thing would be worship teams. If you are interested in being part of a worship team, it does not have to be every week. If you're interested in playing an instrument or singing or reading, please let me know, and I will we'll check about what your schedule's like, and then we'll go from there. And then the other thing is a reminder, and people are doing this, but I'm putting it out just in case some people haven't heard or need that reminder, that if you have song requests, please send them in, and then I will be doing my best to incorporate them where they best fit. All right?
I think that's all for this morning. Don't see anybody else, so I'll ask you to stand and join with me for our closing hymn.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, oh, there's power in the blood. Would you are evil a victory win? 'Cause there's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be free from your passion and pride? There's power in the blood, oh, there's power in the blood. Come for a cleanse into Calvary's tide, 'cause there's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. You be whiter, much whiter than snow. There's power in the blood, oh, there's power in the blood. Sin stains are lost in his life-giving flow, 'cause there's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you do service for Jesus your King? There's power in the blood, oh, there's power in the blood. Would you live daily his praises to sing? 'Cause there's wonderful power in the blood.
Let's sing it now.
There is power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Go in peace. Serve
the Lord. Thanks be to God.